معصية. Indeed, if you walk to an oppressor, tyrant ruler, it is an act of disobedience. فإنه تواضع وإكرام لهم, because that will dignify them and give them an honor that is unwarranted. وقد أمر الله تعالى بالإعراض عنهم, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى ordained us to stay away from them, وهو تكثير لسوادهم, and that will also give them a little bit of legitimacy. وأعانة اللهم على ظلمهم, and that will also aid them to be more oppressive. فإن كان ذلك سبب لطلب أموالهم, and if that's what you're going to ask for their wealth, فهو سعي إلى حرام, and that indeed will be going towards unlawful means. وقد قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من تواضع لغني صالح لغناه ذهب ثلث دينه. When Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, those who are humble themselves for a rich righteous person because of his wealth, two-thirds of your religion is gone. And so he says, وَهَذَا فِي غَنِيٌ صَالِحٌ. And that hadith is regarding a righteous, obedient slave. فَمَا ظَنُّكَ بِالْغَنِيِّ الظَّالِمِ. And what do you think of its rich oppressor? If we are not supposed to go to a rich that is righteous, we are not supposed to go to a rich that is oppressor indeed. وعلى الجملة فحركاتك وسكناتك بأعضائك نعمة من نعم الله عليك. And everything that you move from the actions and deeds is a blessing and a pressure of Allah سبحانه وجل في علي upon you. فلا تحرك شيئا منها في معصية الله عز وجل أصلا. So don't move anything that is, if it comes to the act of disobedience to Allah سبحانه وجل في علي. Here I'm going to have to just remind, I remember one of the Sahaba رضوان الله عليه أجمعين, he used to say, والله ما حركت قدمه. By Allah, I never moved a قدم, a foot. And illa, except I ask myself, هل كانت في طاعة أم في معصية? I ask myself before I move my feet anywhere, is this going to be an act of obedience to Allah or is it going to be an act of disobedience to Allah? فإن كانت في طاعة, if it was for an act of obedience, I would have actually gone, used my feet to take me there. وإن كانت في معصية, but if it was an act of disobedience, I would have forbidden myself to be carried by the feet that Allah has given me to go to commit an act of disobedience in the sight of Allah سبحانه وجل في علاه. So he says, واستعملها في طاعة الله. So if that's the case, use it for the obedience of Allah, not in the disobedience of Allah. واعلم أنك إن قصرت فإليك يرجع وباله. And know for sure, if you shortchange yourself, and you will be actually bearing the burden upon yourself. فَإِلَيْكَ تَعُودُ وَإِنْ شَمَّرْتَ فَإِلَيْكَ تَعُودُ ثَمَرُهُ. So if you do something bad, you will carry the burden. But if you do something well and hold back from that, you will receive the reward from what you've sown. وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكَ وَعَنْ عَمِلِكَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would mean nothing, insignificant. He's independent of you and doesn't need your actions and deeds. وَإِنَّمَا كُلُّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ رَهِينَةٌ. And indeed, everyone will be held accountable of what they've done. وَإِيَّاكَ أَن تَقُولَ. And what you if you say, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى كَرِيمٌ رَحِيمٌ يَغْفِرُ ذُنُوبَ الْعُصَاةِ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ulah, He is generous, He is most merciful, He will forgive the sins of those who are disobedient to Him. فَإِنَّ هَذِهِ كَلِمَةُ حَقٍّ أُرِيدَ بِهَا بَاطِلٌ. Indeed, that utterance itself, that sentence is true, but it was meant with a falsehood, meaning your intention is not good. Even what you say is true, but the meaning behind it is not. وصاحبها ملقب بالحماقة. He says, the one that says that is an actual idiot. Who said this? He says, بتلقيب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حيث قال. Who said this? Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, anyone says that is an idiot. Let me verify, because of the hadith says, الكيس, meaning the intellectual individual, the calm, cool and collect. من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت. Those who hold themselves accountable and do their actions and deeds what is coming after death. والأحمق, here's the word, that idiot, من اتبع نفسه هواه, من اتبع نفسه هواه وتمنى على الله الأماني. Those who follow their own whims and desires and they have false hopes upon Allah. Yeah, you know what? I'll commit sins. Allah غفور رحيم. Allah will forgive me. He says, no, that is an idiot that he thinks that way. May Allah protect himself from that. I mean, واعلم, and know again, أن قولك هذا يضاهي قول من يريد أن يصير فقيها في علوم الدين. Anything that you say when it comes to this type of measurement sticks, is the exact opposite of those who seek knowledge. Remember, this book was designed for those who are serious of seeking knowledge. Before you go to Ihya Ulum al-Din, the bigger books that he written for the serious seekers of knowledge. So he says, if that's the case, فَفَقِيهًا فِي عُلُومِ الدِّينِ اشتغل بالبطالة وقال. You know what? He's using now falsehood and he says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَرِيمٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah forgives. أنا قادر على يفيد على قلبي من العلوم ما أفاضها على قلوب من أنبيائه. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can fill my hearts with all the knowledge that he filled with his prophets and messengers. غير جهد وتكرار وتعليق. يعني with the, I have no idea where you get this from. But it's false, he says. فَهُوَ قَوْلُ مَنْ يُرِيدَ مَالًا. This is the same person that wants money. وَتَرَكَ الْحِرَافَ وَالْتِجَارَةَ وَالْكَسْبُ وَتَعَطَّلُ. Those who leave, you're not even taking the land to do it. You're not buying and selling. You're not working. You're not doing anything. But you say, إِنَّ اللَّهُ كَرِيمُ وَلَهُ خَزَانِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah is most generous and he has the treasures of the heavens and the earth. وَهُوَ قَادِرٌ عَلَى يُطْلِعَنِي عَلَى كَنْزٍ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ فَأَسْتَغْنِي بِهِ عَنِ الْكَسْبِ. And he is able to give me a source of provisions that I don't have to work. Of course he is. But Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi ula is already, it says it, ittikhadna bil asbab. The acts of what? Taking the causes, providing what the plan is all about, doing your best in order for you to attain the wealth. Even in Surah Al-Kahf that you're supposed to read every Friday, says fa'atba'a sababa. Even the king at the time, the strong king, Dhul-Qarnayn, the one that went to the east and the west, he says, فَأَتْبَعَ سَبَبَ. He took the causes. Even Maryam alayhi salam, even though she's a woman, pregnant, weak, on her own, says, Huzzi, shake the trunk of a palm tree. Men cannot shake the trunk of a palm tree. But you still have to take the causes. Don't sit back and chill and do nothing. So he says, فَأَنْتَ إِذَا سَمَعْتَ كَلَامَ هَذَيْنَ الرَّجُلَيْنِ اسْتَحْقَمْتَهُمَا. And if you hear the sayings of those two types of people, you will say, these people are idiots. وسخرت منهما, and you make a mockery of them. وإن كان ما وصفاه من كرم ومن كرم الله وقدرته حقا وصدقا. And even if they say from the fountains of abundance of bounties of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fi la truth, and it is exactly what he said, فكذلك يضحك عليك أرباب البصائر الذين إذا طلبت المغفرة من غير سعي لها. Of course it's true, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do so, but we're not asked to do, sit back and chill and collect pogi and whatever it is that you want, akhi. We're supposed to work and do our best. That's what Islam is all about. So if that's the case, you cannot fall on the false pretense that those two type of men to do so. And if you do the sins and asking Allah to forgive you without having to do something that is to warrant of forgiveness, it is not validated. Wallahu ta'ala yaqulu laka wa alaysa lil insani illa ma sa'a. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you will not be receiving the reward except what you planted, what you earned. Wa yaqulu azza wa jalla innama tujzawna ما كنتم تعملون. You will be rewarded for what you've done, what you've earned. ويقول عز وجل إن الأبرار لفي نعيم. Indeed, the righteous, the benevolence, will be in an abundance of eternal pleasure. May Allah make us among them, يا رب. آمين. وإذ لم يترك الإنسان السعي في طلب العلم والمال اعتمادا على كرمه عز وجل فكذلك لا يترك التزود الآخرة. And if you want to ask, seek knowledge, if you want to get the reward in this life, how could you leave what is going to grant you the eternal happiness and pleasure? You leave the work for that? Says it doesn't make any sense. ولا تغتر فإن رب الدنيا والآخرة واحد. And don't be fooled. The Lord of the dunya is the same Lord of the hereafter. It is the same Lord. وهو فيهما كريم رحيم. Indeed, he is generous and merciful. ولا يزيد له كرم. The last half a page, inshallah. بمؤنك وإنما كرمه أن يسهل عليك طريق الوصول إلى الملك المقيم. You know what? It's not him doing this to make it difficult for you, but it's to make it easy for you to get to where you are. But you have to work for it. You cannot just sit back and do nothing and accept it and accept to get it. المخلد بالصبر على ترك الشهوات أياما قلائل وهذا نهاية الكرم. And indeed, Allah سبحانه وجل في علاه, from his eternal boundaries and generosity, will give you eternal pleasure for you being patient on very few days. What does he mean? He means this life. أيام معدودات. فلا تحدث نفسك بهوسات البطالين. Don't take the mockery, don't listen to the people who actually make no sense. واقتدي بأولي الحزم والنهي ونوها من الأنبياء والصديقين والصالحين. But take as a role model the أولي النوها, meaning the أولي العقول, the intellect and the believers strong, worthy of those who follow the footsteps of the prophets and the righteous and the truthful ones. ولا تطمع في أن تحصد ما لا تزرع. And don't be greedy or false hopes to seep what you have not planted. وليت من صلى وصام وجاهد واتقى غفر له. And we only ask Allah subhanahu wa jalla fiula for those who strive in the path of Allah and pray and fast and do their best for Allah subhanahu wa jalla fiula to forgive them. This is the last note and according of this bab of this chapter and section is وهذه جمل ما ينبغي أن تحفظ عنه جوارحك الظاهرة. And that is the completion of comprehensive way that you should protect of your own limbs, the what is apparent. وأعمال هذه الجوارح إنما تترشح من صفات القلب. But indeed those limbs will only belong to a king, meaning these are the soldiers, to a king which is the heart. فإن أردت حفظ الجوارح, so if you want to protect your limbs, فعليك بتطهير القلب. And indeed you have to purify your heart. فهو التقوى الباطن. And that is the pre-conscious way that you are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa jalla fila, which is unseen. والقلب هو المضغة إذا التي إذا صلحت, and that is the morsel of flesh if it's righteous, صلح بها جسد الأسد الجسد. He says the rest of the body will also be righteous. وإذا فسدت, and if it was spoiled, فسد بها سائر الجسد, and the rest of the body will be also spoiled. فاشتغل بإصلاحه لتصلح به جوارحك. And that's the end of this, inshallah. So make sure that you preoccupy yourself with fixing your heart so the rest of your body will be fixed. We ask Allah subhanahu wa jalla fila to give us قلب سليم, a serene heart and a body that proves the taqwa with inside our heart to show that Allah subhanahu wa jalla fila looks at our hearts, not anything else. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salam ala alihi wa sahbihi wa tabi'in. Jazakum Allah anna khaira. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.